5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। सर, द थ्री विंग्स ऑफ डिफेंस, द आर्मी, द नेवी एंड द एयरफोर्स रिक्वायर टू बी वेल इक्विप्ड एंड मॉडर्नाइज्ड। आवर्स इज अ कंट्री विद अ ग्रेट पॉपुलेशन। आई नो आवर डिफिकल्टीज आल्सो। इन द प्रेजेंट वर्ल्ड सिचुएशन इट विल नॉट बी पॉसिबल फॉर अस टू रिमेन सेकेंड रेट इन रिगार्ड टू पोजेशन ऑफ मॉडर्न आर्मामेंट्स। डिफेंस इज अ वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड प्रॉब्लम नाउअडेज इन दिस वर्ल्ड। वी हैव नॉट गॉट दैट टेक्निकल नो हाउ। वी हैव नॉट गॉट दोज टेक्नीशियंस हु कैन मैन्युफैक्चर मॉडर्न वीपन्स इन आवर कंट्री। इवन देन द डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री इज एफिशिएंट। इट हैज ट्राइड टू मैन्युफैक्चर एज फार एज पॉसिबल न्यू मशीनरी एंड मॉडर्न वीपन्स। Then the problem of development is equally, or if I may say so, more important. It all depends upon how we progress. To save the future of our country requires huge funds of money. We are a poor country. And I am told that taxation in our country is the highest compared to other countries of the world. The question therefore arises as to how we shall meet the situation. New wealth has to be created. New sources of wealth have to be explored. And in these matters, we cannot depend upon friendly countries for coming to our aid in times of necessity. The country must have that self-reliance, and in course of time, it should be our aim to reach that stage when this country can produce all its requirements, can have its own defense, can have its own development, and can stand on its own legs. If I were to dilate on this, it will take a very long time. And everybody in this house knows the difficulties and the complications of the situation. But even then, I might suggest that this question of development requires to be very carefully handled. Now, wealth comes from two sources. One is agriculture and the other is industry. And agriculture is the main base for development purposes. But what do we find about the position of agriculture in our country? I think our Prime Minister suggested that in all the states, the Chief Minister should take over the portfolio of agriculture, looking to its importance in the situation. But I do not find any Chief Minister caring to accept the suggestion and take over the portfolio of agriculture in his hands. That shows how serious we are in meeting the situation. Agriculture, sir, depends upon millions of small agriculturists in our country. एंड इन स्पाइट ऑफ आवर प्लानिंग दोज हु आर कनेक्टेड विद द रूरल एरियाज दोज हु आर इंटीमेटली कनेक्टेड विद एग्रीकल्चर नो दैट एग्रीकल्चरिस्ट डू नॉट फील एंथ्यूज्ड डिस्पाइट प्लानिंग फॉर सो मैनी ईयर्स द सेम ओल्ड रट कंटिन्यूज अनलेस वी एंथ्यूज देम अनलेस वी मेक देम फील दैट दे आर द बिल्डर्स ऑफ द कंट्री दैट दे आर द मोल्डर्स ऑफ द फ्यूचर ऑफ दिस कंट्री एग्रीकल्चर विल नॉट प्रॉस्पर देयर आर सो मैनी रीजन्स बट द मेन रीजन इज दैट द एग्रीकल्चरिस्ट मस्ट फील दैट ही हैज सम इम्पॉर्टेंट प्लेस इन आवर कंट्री दैट ही इज डूइंग अ ग्रेट सर्विस बाई इंश्योरिंग हायर प्रोडक्शन फॉर दैट पर्पज इट इज़ वेरी नेसेसरी दैट द पर एकर प्रोडक्शन मस्ट इंक्रीज मोर लैंड इज नॉट अवेलेबल फॉर कल्टिवेशन पॉपुलेशन इज राइजिंग बाई लीप्स एंड बाउंड्स देयर इज द क्वेश्चन ऑफ अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट एंड ऑल्सो We find that the pressure on land is very much. If we want agriculture to prosper, that pressure on land, the number of human beings dependent on agriculture has to be reduced and where shall we divert them? If they go to urban areas for employment, they do not get it. The figure of unemployment is rising every day. Therefore, it is very necessary to see that some industries are diverted to rural areas. We should create agro-industrial climate in the country. We have been talking of creating this climate all these years, but in that part of the country from which I come, I have not seen any industries on a necessary scale being established in the rural areas. Unless we do this, the youngsters from the rural areas are bound to come to the cities. There will be the question of unemployment, the question of housing, the question of sanitation. All these problems will arise. It is very necessary that we find useful employment for them in the rural areas, in the villages in which they live, and they must have a decent standard of living. With the progress of primary education, with these new modes of transport, people from the villages now come frequently to the cities and see what facilities, what amenities are available in the cities and how backward their villages are comparatively in respect of these amenities, and they feel dissatisfied with the life they lead, and therefore they are inclined to go in for better prospects for a better life. They want to go to the cities. That is also a very serious situation for the government to consider. The problem of rural employment must be solved on a war footing.